Okay, so we're going to do our step forward the exact same. We're just going to go ahead and download our image of our ranch by clicking here. And then we'll click the download in the top right. Go ahead, drag and drop that onto our desktop. Hold control, click, and open with Adobe Photoshop. Now we're going to keep working with our selection tools. And we're going to show... Start really playing around with our adjustment layers now. So be sure that you have your image open. We're gonna go ahead and unlock this background to get us started here. And to do that, you're just gonna click that lock that was right here. Next, what we're gonna do is grab the quick selection tool. That's the fourth tool down. You can click and hold if you don't see it. And it should look like a little paintbrush with some dotted lines around it. Now you can also use the key command W to then get that for you as well. So you can press W on your keyboard and that'll be that shortcut. Before you start making your selection, be sure that you have your little plus up here. So that way we're adding to our selection versus subtracting. So be sure you have that selected. And then I'm gonna make my brush size or my selection size a little bit bigger. So I'm just gonna click this down arrow and make that maybe like 25. If yours is really, really big, I would say go ahead and turn that down to something a little more manageable. You could probably get away with something between like 100 and 49. I'll go ahead and select 49 and get started. So once we have that selected, we want to be sure we have our layer 0 selected. And now we're going to select everything inside underneath this mountain. So we're going to select the road, everything underneath here, everything but the sky. So I'm gonna start here on my left. I'm gonna click, hold, and drag, and just start going around that edge to then select that mountain. Now, if you end up selecting too much, that's okay. Just make your whole selection for what you can. And notice how I'm just kind of brushing on the inside here to be sure I have it all selected. And you want all your marching ants to go around your mountains and then down to the bottom edge of this. And be sure that you don't have anything selected or any marching ants happening in here, because then you'll have to redo it. Now, let's say you accidentally made too much of your selection up here in your sky. That's okay. You can just hold Option on your keyboard and then you can go through and then click and then drag that back down. Now, if you want, and I would always recommend zooming in just to be sure that you have selected all that. So again, that's Command Plus. And spend time if you want going through. This doesn't really matter for right now, but just for demonstration purposes, you want to be sure that you have a good selection. So if you have different parts and pieces that are noticeably missing, you want to be sure that you have those selected. So again, I'm just zooming in, holding Option if I need to, but just making sure that I have that whole mountain ridge selected. Now, once you have that whole mountain ridge good and selected, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go right down here to this half moon icon, and we're gonna click that, and we're gonna get this menu that pops up. And we are gonna go and select brightness and contrast. Now, what that's done is that's given us what we call a layer mask up here. That now has made it so any changes that we make are only going to happen to what we selected. So similar to that flower, we're gonna add a brightness and contrast on here. So all we need to do is just drag our sliders. Notice if I take it all the way to the right, it gets really bright. If I take it to the left, it gets super dark. Now with all of these, you wanna be sure that you're just making small adjustments. So you don't need to make anything crazy, but just enough to kind of make those enhance. Now, when you first get started on making some of these edits, you might not know what the difference is. So be sure to take it all the way to the end just to see what it does. And then just kind of bring it back slowly and kind of see what's feeling right to you. Something like this is feeling pretty good for me. So it's a little bit brighter, a little bit higher in contrast. And then that way the sky kind of falls back and gives me a little bit more depth there. Now, once we've finished making our adjustments, if you do still see your marching ants on here, so for example, if you still for some reason see all your marching ants and you want those to go away because you're going to need to make a selection to something else, all you need to do is just press Command D as in Derek on your keyboard, and that will deselect your selection. Now from here, we're just going to go up. We're going to go down to File, go to Save a Copy. We're just going to select Save on your computer. Add our last name, comma first initial, underscore, and then be sure you're saving that as a JPEG to your desktop, and then go ahead and submit. And we're going to move on to that last one next. We're going to be using the Marquee tool.